Thank you for joining us. I'm Courtney Cole with the WBZ News Update. Let's go ahead and take a look at our top stories. The man accused of stealing a purse and stabbing a Good Samaritan hit his face as he appeared in court in Malden. Police say 26-year-old Jason C. bit and stabbed the man after he stole a purse from a woman. This was all yesterday. He's now facing charges today of assault with intent to murder and armed robbery. The town of Danvers just banned all outdoor water use. That means no sprinklers, no irrigation systems, or even hoses are allowed at any time. The town had to make the move due to those low river levels and drought conditions. And those who violate the ban, well, they'll get a warning letter. And then after that, they could face a $300 fine. All right, welcome back. Schools across the state are back in session this week. Today was the first day for students in Waltham, and many teachers and students, you know, parents and kids too, we spoke with, are feeling like it's a bit more normal than the past 2 years. Now let's go ahead and get a check of our next weather forecast with meteorologist Zack Green. Hey, Zack.
How are you, Courtney? Yeah, we're back into the summer heat this afternoon. Partly to mostly sunny skies, and the humidity is going to be sky high. So a bit uncomfortable right up until the end of the day. We'll start to pull in a front through the overnight hours, and that's ultimately going to bring us some rain chances. But if you're thinking about heading outdoors, you want to get towards the beach, the sand may actually be our relief. Now, UV index still sky high with limited cloud cover, so sunblock is going to be necessary. Water temperatures dependent on where you are. North Shore up into Cape Ann, you guys are into the upper 60s and low 70s, feeling like bathwater to Martha's Vineyard as well as Nantucket, between 73 and 75 degrees. There's that front that we're waiting upon. It's going to bubble things up on the eastern side of New York State just around 8 p.m. So you notice the defined line here, yellow, orange, red, all indicating some of the heavier rainfall rates. We'll lose a lot of the steam as it pushes through southern New England. So the Commonwealth, yeah, we may have some steadier pockets just prior to sunrise out through Worcester County. We'll get more of the spillover effect between 6 and 9 a.m. for the eastern side of the state. That means anybody starting school year will probably have to be rain ready at the bus stop. It's not lasting all day long, though. Shorts and t-shirts once again as we go into the afternoon. We'll brighten up and we'll land into the 80s. We'll continue to fall off, though, and the humidity is going to wipe clean as we go through the late week into the low 80s on Thursday, upper 70s on Friday. We get a little boost for our holiday stretch, but there may be a slight rain chance from Sunday into Monday, Courtney, so that's going to be the emphasis in the next few days.
All right, thanks, Zack. We still have a few more of those beach days to squeeze in. I'm Courtney Cole. This has been a WBZ News Update. Have a good day.